Well, well, well. What do we have here? This is a surprise. Honestly, never mind. Nah, I'm just kidding. But honestly, never mind. Drake's latest and surprise album has taken everyone by surprise, including myself. And I have to speak about this. The same way I spoke about Certified Lover Boy, which I thought was a good album. There was key songs on the album that made it good. Like, for instance, Fair Trade, Yabba's Heart Ache, or sorry, Yabba's Heartbreak, Champagne Poetry. Those songs were so good. To me, I think it made the album overall just a good to mediocre album. But honestly, never mind. I'm trying to think of the approach Drake took with it, because first off, I'm just gonna spoil it right now. I think this is a fantastic album. This is a fantastic, fantastic album. No trolling, no meme. I genuinely think this is a fire album, and I'll get into why I think that in a moment, because I don't want to make this video too long. But if you remember back when Drake did If You're Reading This It's Too Late, it was a surprise mixtape, but it was released as an album. Either way, it was a surprise project, and I feel as though Drake was taking an approach of, okay, I got all these throwaway kind of tracks or tracks that I'm working on, you know what, I may as well just finish these and put them out as a mixtape. Because I think Views from the Six was coming out around that time anyway, or it just came out, either way. So he just put it out. It was just a this is something for the fans kind of thing. Fast forward to 2022, we get, and I feel at times as fans of an artist, we get either spoiled or we start to feel entitled. And that's what I feel some fans are. We got Certified Lover Boy last year, and there was a huge build up to that album. And I feel as though certain things impact the levels of expectations when it comes to Drake and his projects. Because we should never forget, Drake is an artist. His artistry comes before anything else, because you have to be inspired to create art. That's where the talent stems from, right? And Drake being a gifted artist, I mean, I've said it many times, he's my favorite artist of all time. I think he's the GOAT, right? But with that, I still give criticism when needed, because I'm not blinded by it. Even though he's my favorite, I still will be fair in terms of my listening experiences to the work that he produces and puts out. So he put out Certified Lover Boy, and I feel as though the leaks prior to the album coming out affected the levels of expectations for when the album did come out. For me, if he'd have put together some of the songs that were leaked and put them in order sequentially with the songs that came out with Certified Lover Boy, that would have been an instant classic. Like, I have the classic, basically. I have all the leaked songs, and when I put them together in a certain order on my Apple Music, it's a continuous play. There's no reason to skip any song. This is just quality music, right? But he didn't do that. He put out the songs, some of them that wasn't leaked, and some of the songs that just wasn't as good as the ones that were leaked. But that was a decision that was made in the studio, whatever. This is just my assumption anyway. The album was good to mediocre regardless, so it did good enough. Fast forward to Honestly Never Mind. I think because of, and we could, funny enough, we could kind of blame Jack Harlow for this in a way, because he has a good relationship with Drake at the moment, right? Well, they're really, really cool with each other, right? Cool. That's great. Drake blessed Jack Harlow with a feature on Churchill Downs that is one of the best features he's ever done, I think. And a lot of people feel that way. So right there, the levels of expectations has risen. If that is what he is on, in terms of his rapping, his approach, his content, the context of what he's saying, we're in for a treat when it comes to whatever he releases next, right? Same thing with Certified Lover Boy. If these leaks are anything to go by, Certified Lover Boy must be a phenomenal album based on these leaks. I feel like people base their expectations on certain tracks here and there that Drake has featured on, but primarily the Jack Harlow track Churchill Downs that he's featured on, which comes to my opinion of Honestly Nevermind, the album. I think this is a 9 out of 10, an album. And the reason I say that is, for you to like this album, one, you have to have no expectations, which is good. Why he released it as a surprise album. There's no leaks, your expectations can be subdued because it just came out of nowhere. It's a gift as well. It's just, here you go, here's 14 tracks. And that's what goes into the entitlement of some fans. It's like, this is 14 free tracks, first off. And secondly, if you like One Dance, More Life, Just Hold On, We're Going Home. He's got a song with Wizkid as well. Another song with Wizkid. If you like those songs, there's no reason. Oh, the song that he produced for Virgil and his fashion show with Louis Vuitton, I think it's called Signs, which is one of my favorite songs. That song is so fire. If you like those songs, there is no, I don't feel like there's no feasible reason for you not to love this album. And I'm not trying to justify why it's good. I'm just giving a basic opinion on the album. I like and love One Dance. I like and love Signs. I like a lot More Life. And Just Hold On, We're Going Home. These are all great songs to me. Like, they just naturally are great songs to me. So this album is full of that to me. And I'll end this video on one last note. The album is just a great album. I want to get back to listen to into it now. It is a moment album as well. Like, if you're driving, or if you're in the gym, or if you're on holiday, or if you're in a party, club, it's going to just feel like a great album. It's going to feel like, yeah, these songs really suit the mood. I think it was Future that released a song not long ago. As a matter of fact, it was Valentine's Day. He released a song. Valentine's Day is the worst day, right? On Drake's Instagram, he reposted a slowed down version of that song from a YouTuber. I forgot his name, but he posted that. That was kind of a hint, really, as to where Drake's vision was kind of going, because the slowed down community, when it comes to music and slowing down songs, is a big community. And I feel like this album, Honestly Nevermind, kind of competes with that or against that. Because if you think about it, these songs, if you slow them down, it won't really, some of them or a couple of them or a few of them might work, but they're already slowed down already. So it's like he's tapping into that kind of way of putting out your music, having like a slowed down version of songs. If you go on YouTube and just type in slowed down or chopped and screwed versions of songs, some of these songs have millions and millions of views because some of them sound better than their original versions. I feel like this album is kind of tapping into that kind of thing, and it's great. And it's good that he's doing that. It just goes to show how versatile of an artist he is and has become. And he's always preached that he's going to just, you know, he can't just recreate Take Care. Like, that was a moment in time. Yes, it's a classic. yes, people would love to have a sequel to that, but it just doesn't work like that. Inspiration doesn't work like that. If that was the case, he would have made 10 of them already. But it doesn't. Any artist would tell you that inspiration drives you to creating whatever comes from that inspiration that inspired you in the first place. So this is a fantastic album. I almost feel like it's better than Certified Lover Boy, personally. Time will tell, but it also sounds like a more complete album. Like, all the songs sound cohesively blended well together.
Part of loving it is a challenge, right? Like, I need new challenges. So, you know, people often question, like, oh, why, you know, all of a sudden you're switching your accent and making this type of music. It's not that. It's just, you know, at the end of the day, I can't just keep doing the same thing over and over again, because one, you'll get used to it and then you'll be over it. And two, for me, it's like, you know, I want to try my hand at something. And, yeah. You know, I don't really think I fucked it up yet.
Especially the last track. If you listen to track 13 and let it go straight into the intro, it blends more together as opposed to the 21 Savage track, which I think was just a bonus. He just added that just to please some rap heads, I guess. Hip-hop heads. But it is a fire track as well. When it comes to Certified Lover Boy, I listen to 4 to 3 songs of the album constantly. Like, constantly to this day. This Honestly Nevermind album by Drake, I feel like there's going to be more songs I'm going to be listening to months down the line. And we just hit summer, so I'm going to be listening to this all throughout summer and holidays that I travel to and stuff. This is a 9 out of 10. Straight 9 out of 10. Drake is the GOAT, and that's just my thoughts. But let me know what you think of the album if you've heard it. Let me know what you think of the tracks. And like the video if you haven't liked the video already. I'm probably going to be playing, I don't know what game, I'm thinking about playing Devil May Cry 5 or Bloodhunt with the album playing in the background over on Twitch. So follow me on Twitch if you're not following me already. That's twitch.tv/CaviarZaddy. And I'll catch you all in the next video.
I wouldn't say most concise. I mean, I don't think I'm going to be able to ever make like a 12, 13 song album, but only because, and this is what I want people to give me credit for. The reason why you'll never get like that 10 song classic, 11 song, because, you know, that's 40's thing. Oh, I need the 10 that's song.
45 minutes. What's that?
Yeah, I need the 11 song Drake classic, but I'm the only one that has a commitment to do two things. I have to do two things every album. I have to give the people that like to hear the singing enough to hold on to, and I have to give my, you know, I have to give Bron enough bars for him to, you know, that's my guy, yeah. Bron and Matt. Those are my bar. We have a bar group chat. It's like, we bar up on each other all the time, straight, just freestyle battles in the group chat. Those are my rap guys, you know? And of course, like, the Elusive One, you know, is another guy who, like, is always gonna love, you know, love the other records, but the ones that we connect on.